Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, the troubles will be out of, troubles will be out of sight, of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, your troubles will be miles away. They will be miles away, away.
Was the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. Then what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer, with a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick.
More rapid than eagles his reindeer all came, and he shouted, "On, Dasher," and reindeer's name. So up to the housetop the reindeer soon flew, with the sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. Down the chimney he came with a leap and a bound. He was dressed all in fur, his belly was round. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
And laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like a down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Birth of Jesus Christ. In those days a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went out from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
The shepherds and the angels. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger.
Last reading for Ousedale School, the visit of the wise men from Matthew chapter 2 verses 1 to 12. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet. And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a great ruler, who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring him to me, so that I may come and worship him." After listening to the king, they went on their way. And behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way.
Close the door. Enjoyed our virtual carol service, not our usual concert in the hall, but or in the church even at this time. But thank you very much for listening. Thank you particularly to the music department for putting this together and all the students who played or read readings for us. We hope as a family you enjoyed viewing. Most of all, we hope for you after this really difficult year and challenging term, where I'm sure some of your children have been in and out of school. We hope you find time over Christmas to have some peace and have some time together, even if it's on the driveway or if it's socially distanced. So it just goes for me to say thank you for all your support over the years, and I wish you all a very happy Christmas.